Hi all, this is Sanoop here. For the last 2 months, many of them are behind taking a health insurance policy. It is just because of the most scary word, COVID. So many people have a doubt whether the health insurance covers COVID, how it gets covered, and what are the terms associated with the health insurance and all. So when we hear the word health insurance, what we first do is we just Google it, and the first result which we see is policybazaar.com, and we just enter the policybazaar, we give the phone number, name and email ID, and we are locked. Immediately we get a call from the policybazaar agent, and he starts selling out lot of health insurance products to us. And ultimately what happens is that many of them will go and settle with any of the health insurance which have a lesser premium without knowing what are the terms or what are the features associated with that health insurance policy. So in this video, I'll just explain to you what are the different types of health insurances and what are the simple terms which is associated with the health insurance and what all we should check before taking a health insurance policy. So let's get started. So let's get started with the first word. It is NCB or no claim bonus. Many of them will be knowing what a no claim bonus is, and some of them won't be knowing. So imagine you have a car and you have an insurance for your car, and you did not claim anything for a damage which happened to your car. Okay, what happens is that when you renew in the next year, you get a discount. So similarly, for a health insurance, what majority of the company gives is no claim bonus. If you take an insurance and you did not claim it for the next year, you get a bonus known as no claim bonus. For example, I have a policy of 5 lakhs and imagine the no claim bonus is 20%. Okay, so I don't take any claim in that policy for the first year, and the next year when I renew, I have a no claim bonus of 20%. I get 6 lakhs, and in the second year I did not make any claim, then that 6 lakh will become 7 lakhs. So majority of the health insurance companies will give this benefit called as no claim bonus. Okay, there will be a maximum limit for a no claim bonus. Some of the companies will say it is 50%. Some of the other companies will tell it is 100%. So a 5 lakh policy, if you are not claiming for a consecutive years, maximum you will get a cover of 10 lakhs. So it is a very useful feature, and one thing which you have to see is that some insurance policies, if you claim in between, they charge a penalty. So never take an insurance policy which charges a penalty when you claim. Instead, take an insurance policy which gives a no claim bonus with no additional cost, so that itself is a bonus to us. The second word is restoration benefit or refilling benefit. So some of them will be asking, what do you mean by restoration benefit? When you take a health insurance from an agent, for a 5 lakh policy, they will say it is 10 lakh policy. Okay, and when you ask how it became 10 lakh, they will say 5 lakh base policy plus 5 lakh restoration benefit. So what is this restoration benefit? I'll give you an example. You take a family cover of 5 lakh rupees, okay? And the father was admitted in the hospital and he got a bill of 4 lakh rupees. Okay, imagine. And the very next month, your mom got admitted and she got a claim of around 3 lakh rupees. So actual policy just covers for only 5 lakh rupees. But since this policy have a restoration benefit or a refilling benefit, it offers an additional 100% of the base cover as a restoration benefit. There is a lot of conditions for this. The most important condition is that money cannot be used for the same disease. In my earlier example, father itself can't use that money, the additional 5 lakhs, on her same disease. Okay, so it can be used by some other person in the family, or father himself can use it for another disease. So majority of the companies will give this refilling benefit or a restoration benefit 100% of your base cover. So this is also a good feature for health insurance. So you have to check if your policy provides this feature. There is one more condition. I'll give you another example. Sometimes you have a policy of 5 lakh rupees and your parent needs a treatment for cancer and that costs 7 lakh rupees. You won't get this restoration benefit because that 7 lakh rupees is given at one shot for a disease. What maximum you can get for a disease is just 5 lakhs. The third thing which you should know is nothing other than copay. Many of them might have heard the word copay. So if you just go to Google and search for health insurance, you land up in Policy Bazaar and you can see some policies with lesser premiums, and in a small letters it would be written 20% copay or 10% copay. So what do you mean by copay? Copay means when a claim comes, you also have to make a small copayment. Okay? For example, you have a policy of 1 lakh and that policy have a copay of 20%. So if the bill comes for 1 lakh, the insurance company pays only 80,000. The rest of the 20% copay, that is 20,000 rupees, you have to put from your pocket. So this is a big catch. When you search online, you can see majority of the policies with lesser premium having copay. So majority of the people who takes insurance from the website without knowing ends up in premiums which are lower, and later they find out that this policy have a copay. So always see that the policy which you take doesn't have a copay. And another important thing is that some of the policies will have copay if the insured person crosses the age of 60. So always take insurance which does not have copay throughout your life. The next important word which you should know is geographical limit or zone limit. Usually most of the insurance companies divides the cities into zones. There are three zones: zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. Zone 1 is major cities like Bangalore, Delhi, Mumbai. Zone 2 is some of the cities like Chennai, and rest of the other areas will fall into zone 3. So imagine a situation: you take a policy from Kerala with your Kerala address, it falls under zone 3, and you took a treatment from Bangalore, which is a zone 1 area. So you won't get the complete claim amount if you do that. Instead, they will charge a 20% copay. So if you are taking a insurance from zone 3 area and taking a treatment from zone 2, you might need to pay 15% copay. Similarly, if you are taking an insurance from zone 3 area and you are taking treatment from zone 1 area, you need to pay a 20% copay. So it is upon us whether to select an insurance policy which have zone limit, because if you take an insurance which have a geographical limit and if you are in a tier 3 city, zone 3 city, the premium will be very less. But you should know that most of the time you need to take the coverage from zone 3 cities only. So this is not recommended for people who travels all over India. So if you take the policy from Kerala and if you are working in Bangalore, this might not work out. For others who are still in that state itself, you can take that policy with zonal limit. Another most important feature is that lifelong renewal without copay. Some of the insurance company, if you take below the age of 60, after you pass 60, they will charge a 20% copay. So never take insurance which have a copay after 60 years of age. Always take insurance which gives you full freedom to renew it and get the complete claim without any copay. So some of the companies like Religare, they all charge a 20% copay after the age of 60. So better take insurance without all this copay, and which offers you a renew feature for throughout your lifetime. The next thing which you have to watch out for is room sub limit. Majority of them doesn't know about it. Most of the PSU health insurance companies like National, United India, Oriental Insurance, they have the sub limit for room renters. I'll give you an example to get a better picture. You took a policy of rupees 1 lakh and your policy have a sub limit of 1%. Okay, so imagine you took a room of 2000 rupees, okay, and what you have in hand is a 1 lakh policy which have a 1% sublimit. So you took a room of 2000 rupees, and after your treatment the bill comes at around 50,000 rupees. So finally you need to pay half of it, 25,000 rupees, to the hospital itself, because this policy have a room sublimit. It means that the maximum amount which the policy can give claim is for a room is 1000 rupees per day, above which you need to pay from your pocket. And you have to also, many of them will think that this cost is only for the room, but you all should know one thing, that if the room sublimit price increases, all the other expenses like nursing charges, food, and all the treatment charges all increases with respect to the room fare. So room rent. So always take an insurance which does not have any limits like this. Majority of the PSU health insurance companies have this, but some of the private players in insurance space doesn't have this. And the next is pre or post hospitalization expenses. Majority of the insurance companies will pay for your pre and post hospitalization expenses. Imagine you got admitted in a hospital for a stomach disease, okay, and the disease was positive and you got admitted for a week. You can get claim for medicines or any scans or treatments which is taken before 30 days of your admission to the hospital, and maybe after 6 months after you take the after you get discharged from the hospital. So majority of the companies have this feature. Some of the companies will offer 30 days pre-hospitalization and 180 days post-hospitalization. Some provide 60-60. So longer the better. And the next feature is free health checkup. Whenever you hear the term free, we all will jump for it. But don't take this as a point to shortlist which insurance you have to take. Okay, if it is a free, well and good. Always take that free health insurance. Always take that free health checkup. You get a better analysis of your health, and also the health insurance companies also will come to know, okay, what all diseases you have. But it is better to take health checkup if it is provided free by insurance companies. And the next thing is Ayush benefit. Ayush is nothing but Ayurveda, Yunani, homeopathy, and it's a series of other treatments except this allopathy. So some of the health insurance companies will provide a flat fee or a percentage of the sum insured with our health insurance. Imagine you have a insurance of 5 lakh. Some of the companies will give 50% of the amount to get treated in an Ayush hospital. And you can select if you are looking for any other treatments like Ayurveda or homeopathy and all, and you need to get the complete amount. There are health insurance companies which provides 100% of the sum insured for using in this Ayush hospitals. And always know that the hospitals which, if you want to get claim for this Ayush benefit, it has to be registered under NABH. NABH is an accreditation body for all these kinds of hospitals. The 10th point which you have to check is stay healthy discount. Some of the companies like Aditya Birla Health Insurance have something called as health rewards. What it means that you took a health insurance of 5 lakh, imagine the premium is about 10,000 rupees, okay, and they give you an offer. You need to run 10,000 steps for 14 days in a month, and if you do that for all the months, in the next renewal you get 30% discount on your premium. For instead of rupees 10,000, you just need to pay rupees 7,000. Or if you don't want discount, you can also claim it with some other e-commerce gift cards or other hospital visits, etc. So that is a good benefit, health rewards. It's actually a win-win strategy, because if you take this health rewards, in order to get the discount, we also will walk, which makes us healthy. In turn, even the health insurance companies will also have benefit, because if we walk, we all will be free from most of the diseases. Now, the most important point is TPA or third party administration. Majority of the PSU companies like National Health, United India, New India have a TPA appointed for medical insurance claims. So in my personal opinion, it is always better to have a TPA on its own rather than outsourcing it to taking an insurance which is outsourced to some other third party, because there you save a lot of time for claim process. Though the insurance companies which have TPA might take a lot of time, you might need to go to the TPA office in order to settle the claim, and you might need to you might feel a bit difficult to deal with this TPAs instead of this health insurance company. So always go for, not always, it is my personal opinion, go for health insurance companies which have their own TPA. Now another point which you have to see is that there is something called as daily cash limit. Some insurance policies, if you pay some more extra premium, they will give you a daily cash allowance of rupees 1000 rupees per day. But there are plenty of conditions, terms and conditions for this. There's a condition saying that you need to stay for more than 2 days. Some says that you need to stay in a shared room. So you have to check that properly. This is not a big feature in order to select your health insurance. So if you get it, better. Otherwise, it's better not to go for all this feature by paying extra premium. And the next point which you have to see is that exclusion. Majority of the health insurance companies excludes a lot of diseases without giving claim. So that may include admission charges, discharge charges, disposable things charges, service charges, and hospital administrative charges. So almost 15% of the bill amount you might need to pay from your pocket. They also doesn't give claim for neurological diseases like Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, etc. And also some of the health insurance companies doesn't give claim for health the psychiatric diseases, dental, HIV, STDs, alcohol related, maternity and all. So always check what are the diseases which are excluded from the policy which you are taking. And the 15th point which you have to check is that the availability of the TPA office or the health insurance company's office in your city. Because if you have a claim, okay, and you went to a hospital which doesn't have a tie-up with your health insurance company, you need to pay from your pocket. After that, you need to submit the papers in your TPA office. So if it is there in another district and all, you'll be wasting a single day in order to go to their hospital. To their office. So it is always better to take a health insurance company which have an office or a TPA office in your city. The next most important point is that network hospitals. It is not necessary that your health insurance should have a wide range of hospitals, but it is always important to have your preferred hospital as a cashless hospital or a hospital which have a tie-up with them. Because if you are living in a place, you might be knowing if there is an emergency or for a treatment, you will be going to so and so hospitals, okay, rather than a emergency case when you met with an accident. All other cases you will be going to a hospital which you already know or which is near our home. So always see that these hospitals are there in the cashless list of this insurance company, because claiming a cashless transaction is very easy. And it also saves plenty of time. The 17th most important point is that the difference between individual policy and a family floater policy. Majority of them will take a family policy by registering each and every one of them as an individual. But it is actually a loss for the person who is taking the insurance, because the premium will be too high. So if it is a family, always take a family insurance, father, mother, two children, and take it as a common family floater insurance of a 5 or 10 lakhs. The benefit is that the 10 lakh amount will be claimed by all the four people in the family will be having a claim over this 10 lakh amount, instead of each and every individual having 10 lakh independently. So you save a lot of amount on the premium. So it is, if you have our family, it is always better to go for a family floater insurance. The next important point which you have to see is a word called as topper policy or super topper policy. So what do you mean by topper policy? It means that you already have a health insurance for 5 lakh. That is your base policy. And there might be a situation where you need to get a claim for 10 lakhs. So you already have an insurance of 5 lakhs. So what do? You take a top-up policy, okay, of 10 lakhs. So what happens is that, imagine there are two cases. The first case, you got admitted and the bill comes for around 7 lakh. So here what happens, the base cover of 5 lakhs gets triggered. You get the entire 5 lakh amount. Once the 5 lakh is over, the another top-up policy of 10 lakhs, you get 2 lakhs also. So total the 7 lakh will be covered. Imagine the second case, you have a base policy of 5 lakhs and you got a claim for 4 lakh. So the 4 lakh will get covered and you have a remaining 1 lakh, okay? And the next time after a few months, you got a claim for 3 lakhs. What happens now? Will you get cover? No. In a top-up policy, you get cover only if the claim amount goes above your base policy at one shot. So, in order to solve this problem, there is something called as super top-up policy, which gives claim in this situation. If the claim amount comes in piece and piece, the super top-up policy gives you the claim. So always go for super top policy, don't go for top-up policy. It is expensive, but that is only the useful thing is super top-up policy. So go for it. So hope you all understood the key terms associated with health insurance. So while taking health insurance, always research what kind of product you need, the exact product you need, and go for it. And nowadays there is something called as insurance porting. You are always free to port from one insurance company to another insurance company before 45 days of your renewal time. So you are always free to port from one company to another. And I have taken a lot of insurances, and the one insurance which I took first is insurance from United India in the year 2013. I took the very next day after I got discharged from getting a dengue fever. So always don't go for the right time to purchase a policy. Always purchase a policy when you are young and fit, and never ever forget to renew it. That's the most important thing. And for NRIs, majority of the NRIs will be working abroad and they'll be having health insurance covered there. And they'll be thinking, okay, that is sufficient. But in this scenario, there are certain cases, okay, where there are chances where you need to come back to your home. At that time, after retiring or before that, if you have a job loss or something, and when you reach home, you might be of elder age, okay, you might be 40-45 age, and you might be having other diseases also. So by that time, if you try to take an insurance from India, the chance of having a high premium or having a pre-existing diseases is high. So it is always better to take a health insurance wherever you are in the part of the world. Always take a health insurance before when you are young and fit. And if you have any doubts regarding the health insurance, you are always free to ask. You can comment here below. I shall reply when I get time. And thanks a lot for watching. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask. And also please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.